That'll come in handy. Don't know why I never remember to buy one. The mask symbol again. Looks like someone's been trying to make a point. A few more questions, if you don't mind. Seen this? You know the shop?
Yeah, I know the shop. I hired something from them last year, I think.
It's for a party, I assume.
Yeah, something like that.
What do you know about Paul stealing money from students, part of a stunt or something?
What, did he do that? I've never heard about anything like that. No, it might be part of the risk-taking thing, though.
Explain that.
Well, it's part of the course. You have to do something dangerous or risky, something you wouldn't normally do.
Something dangerous?
Well, not dangerous, just risky. Like saying something you wouldn't normally say to someone, or doing something unusual.
Like stealing from other students.
Well, we didn't do anything like that, but you have to tell everyone at the end of the course anyway. And you're not allowed to do anything that would hurt or offend anyone. Oh, you're not allowed to do anything really bad. It's all pretend, really.
It seems a bit odd for a business course.
It works, though.
What do you know about doll burning?
Not on the course. It's a ritual thing. It's getting rid of things that you don't need. Throw it into the fire.
And that's a good thing?
Well, yeah, it helps you getting rid of things you don't need, so you can move on and take control again.
So what are the masks for?
They're just to help you get into the right frame of mind. Just get you into the zone, you know, help with the trance.
A trance?
Yeah. It's like self-hypnosis. We do it on the course sometimes. It's just to help you get into the right frame of mind, you know?
So you hypnotize yourself. How do you do that?
Just stare into a mirror and chant something, you know, just say the same thing over and over again. Or you could just close your eyes and put yourself into a trance. Some people can do that.
And that's safe?
Well, yeah. Hypnosis doesn't work the way that most people think it does. You can't just be hypnotized if you don't want to be hypnotized. But you can learn to hypnotize yourself.
What did you say it was called? Auto-hypnosis?
Self-hypnosis, auto-hypnosis, same thing, really.
I think Simon was a bit too quick to play down the role of auto-hypnosis on the course. I'll have to ask around about this. What do you know about Ryan's guitar collection?
Not a whole lot. I know he brought a guitar to one of the groups once, at the end of one of the stages. That's the only time I've seen him with a guitar.
Have you seen these before?
No. Don't know the car.
Thank you. Probably be back later. A few more questions, if you don't mind. Do you know what this is?
Well, I think it's a bag. Is it a bag, Inspector?
The shop.
Oh, yes, the costume shop. Yes, we used to hire from them.
For the course?
Well, yes. For the course, at the end of each stage, we have a little party and we ask students to dress up or try acting out being somebody new, their new selves, as it were.
Could you explain a bit more? New selves?
One of the main elements of the course is learning how to act, how to be whoever you need to be in any given situation. I think you'll agree, Inspector, that business is about being the right person in the right situation at the right time. What it does, it helps them to detach themselves, become somebody new, pretend, you know that kind of thing. It's surprising what a little bit of cross-dressing can do for you, Inspector. You should try it.
Not at this stage. What do you know about your father's money-stealing stunt?
Well, yes, that was something that Dan decided to do as part of the shock aspect of the course.
But he went too far, you believe?
He usually does.
And do you think it did have anything to do with Liam's death?
No. Liam wasn't like that at all. I mean, that was just a simple, unfortunate coincidence. I mean, Liam had his own problems, but he didn't have any problems with the money shock stunt. No.
So tell me more about this doll burning.
It's a symbolic ceremony we perform every few weeks on the course.
What's it about?
It's about burning your old personality and finding a new one, a better one.
So the dolls are...
you. They represent you from the past. Each doll has a picture of the student, a child or a teenager. And they burn the doll and symbolically destroy their old personality. It's quite simple but effective, I find.
And why did that girl shout?
Because it's an emotional thing. She quite clearly become very attached to her doll. They do spend the first month with them. We tell them to take the doll everywhere with them before they actually go through the doll burning.
And you believe that's a good thing? Destroying your past?
Of course it's a good thing, Inspector. We're all shackled to our past. Particularly you, by the sound of it. Perhaps we should make a doll of you, Inspector, and burn that. What do you think?
No, thank you.
You're probably right. I'm not sure it would do any good anyway.
I didn't realise you were a musician.
Oh, well, I'm not really a musician. I mean, I dabble a little bit. To be quite honest with you, I'm far more interested in collecting guitars.
You're not in a band.
Well, I did audition. I did audition a few years ago. Well, I say a few years ago, of course, I mean about 20 years ago. Doesn't time fly?
What band was that?
Oh, I can't remember. Something Stone. Aren't they all called Something Stone? Hammerstone. That's it.
And you still collect?
I haven't bought a guitar for over a year. I feel I've moved on.
What do you know about Emma Bowman criticising Liam before his suicide?
I was there. I witnessed it. I know Emma blamed herself for his death.
Did she?
Well, she was upset and all of that, but I wouldn't blame her, Inspector. I really don't think she had anything to do with it at all.
You don't think?
Liam was a very confident person, very outgoing, very strong individual, or so it seemed. I mean, people are free to do what they like. Even something as irreversible as bumping themselves off. Sad, though, that is, of course.
know what these are?
Oh, yes. That's my old car. It was vandalized. I took those for the insurance company. Where did you find those?
At the pub. You know who did this?
Yes. A girl called Lisa Blint. She was on the course. Very strange girl.
And why did she write the words devil worshippers all over your car?
Well, she was a very strange girl. She had a lot of psychological problems. I'm not entirely sure, Inspector. She took a dislike to the course for some particular reason. I couldn't quite put my finger on it. And she asked for a refund. I declined. And she decided to spray her disapproval all over my car.
Odd thing to spray, isn't it, though? Devil worshippers?
Well, she was a very odd girl, Inspector. Maybe she thought it was a way of getting back at us. I have no idea.
Did Rebecca know about it?
Well, yes, she did, but I wasn't about to unleash Rebecca on her. She can be quite fierce sometimes, you know. And I mean, the girl wasn't vindictive. She had psychological problems. She lives in the village, actually. The run-down house at the end of the lane. Can't miss it.
Really? Right. Thank you. Can you tell me about auto-hypnosis?
Well, what would you like to know?
Do you use it on the course?
We dip into it occasionally, but it's not a major feature of the course. I would say that, well, a minority of the students know how to use it, but the majority wouldn't know and have a clue.
It's not a requirement of the course.
No, not at all. We don't ask people to do things that they're not comfortable with. There's no bribery, no coercion. We're thinking about phasing auto-hypnosis out, actually.
What's the reason for that?
Well, to be perfectly honest with you, Inspector, it doesn't actually work very well.
That's all for the moment. Thank you. Could that be where Lisa lives? Run-down house at the end of the lane. That's what Ryan said, wasn't it? Is it Lisa?
Yes.
Inspector Jenks, I'm investigating an incident in the village. I wonder if I could ask you a few questions.
What sort of incident?
I'd rather come in and discuss it if that's all right with you. I promise I won't take long. Thank you.
I'll just go in here, yes?
I have to go out in a minute.
Oh, look, I can come back later.
I might not be here. What did you want to ask?
I just wanted to ask you, did you know Kate Vine?
No.
Right. Well, I heard that you're familiar with Atlas, the life skills training company.
What do you want to know about Atlas?
Well, I heard you reacted badly to it.
Of course I reacted badly. So would anyone.
Now, why do you say that?
Because they're devil worshippers.
Devil worshippers?
They're making demons appear. They're tricking everybody. They're getting people to join up, then they're putting demons inside them. You can see them.
See who?
Demons.
Where could you see them?
In the mirrors.
At Atlas?
Any mirror. You can't get rid of them. They stay inside you.
So, how did you get rid of them?
I didn't.
You still see them?
I just don't look. I put all the lights on. I make sure it's all bright. I put them on when I need to look in the mirror. If I make sure everything is bright, I just see myself without seeing the other person.
Who is the other person?
She's like me, but older. It's like her eyes sink in. She's all wrinkled, with a wrinkled mouth. Like she's dying. And then I realize I'm her. I'm not me anymore. I'm her. I'm sorry, I have to go now. I'm sorry. I'm sorry.
Questions, if that's okay. Has devil worship ever been part of the course, Ryan?
Am I correct in assuming that you have spoken to Lisa Blint?
You would be. She's been telling me all about the Atlas obsession with Satanism, Ryan.
Then if you've met Lisa Blint, then you will have worked out for yourself that she has a very vivid imagination. She also has psychological problems. Diagnosed psychological problems, as a matter of fact.
So where did she get the idea that you lot were devil worshippers?
I really have no idea. The girl is insane. She's frightened of her own shadow, bless her. She actually thinks that demons are possessing her even now. You really can't trust a word she says.
So you are saying there has never been any devil worship at Atlas?
I don't even know what devil worship is, Inspector. It's not something I particularly know anything about. I certainly don't recall anyone ever having worshipped the devil at Atlas. We even tried to help the poor girl by paying for some treatment, but she didn't want it.
Really?
It's not easy to offer someone help when they think that you're the problem.
Aha. So you used to read a lot about voodoo and satanic rituals, but you don't know anything about devil worship?
Well, obviously, I just meant we don't worship the devil. We're not devil worshippers here at Atlas, Inspector. Ridiculous.
But the point is, Ryan, that you claim not to know anything about it, but admitted you were obsessed with it when you were younger. Are you sure none of that made its way onto the Atlas course? And that Lisa isn't basing her beliefs on anything within that course?
Lisa isn't basing her beliefs on anything other than her own imagination, Inspector. Look, we do use some techniques that some students find difficult, disturbing. We encourage them to see things differently, that's all. And some people simply aren't up to that. Some people, like Lisa, that's why we introduced the aptitude test.
What's the aptitude test?
This. We ask students to fill in an aptitude test. Medical history, psychological issues, that kind of thing. Any medication that they have used in the past. Any medication that they currently are using. Here, take a look. Basically, it's just to try and make sure that we don't get another Lisa.
Has it worked?
Well, touch wood so far, yes.
Can I keep a copy of this? I wonder how much importance they actually give to this test. And what are they doing that's so disturbing anyway? Be back later on, if that's okay. Thank you. A few more questions, please. Thank you. Have you seen this before?
Looks familiar. Where did you find it?
It was in the woods.
Presumably had something to do with Kate or a killer.
Well, that's what I'm trying to establish.
Shouldn't it be in an evidence bag, Inspector, in case of contamination?
I didn't have one with me, unfortunately.
Well, don't go testing it for DNA, will you? It's got yours all over it.
What can you tell me about doll burning at Atlas?
Not very much. It's one of Ryan's ideas. My son is under the illusion that he's a genius.
Does Ryan play the guitar?
Ryan? Ryan couldn't get a tune out of a radio. He's tone deaf.
Okay, so he's never tried to go professional.
If he did try, it was never going to happen.
Do you think Emma's criticism of Liam on that last night led to his suicide?
I doubt it helped.
Did you encourage Emma to criticise him?
I didn't encourage Emma to do anything. I merely told her what we tell every student to do, to express themselves as they want to. It would be out of order to criticise them after that, wouldn't it? However, I didn't expect her to criticise his birthmark, if that's what it was. That's a decision she took herself.
So you didn't know her well?
No, not at all.
Do you know what these are?
Yes, that's Ryan's car. Another toy he managed to ruin. It was vandalized sometime last year.
Do you know who did it?
I don't believe anybody was ever prosecuted for it.
Can you tell me more about the auto-hypnosis techniques used on the course?
We don't use hypnosis on the course.
Not at all?
Not anymore.
So, how was it used?
Hypnosis is probably the wrong word, Inspector. It's nothing to do with the trances or things like that. It was meant to force... to help students.
Did you force them?
You can't force anybody into being hypnotized. You have to want to be hypnotized. It's not something out of your control. You can't be hurt or damaged in any way by hypnosis.
So you've never put pressure on students to enter into hypnosis?
It would be impossible to do so.
Do you know anything about devil worship, Paul?
I beg your pardon?
Devil worship? Satanism?
Am I missing something here?
I heard Atlas had elements of Satanism on the course.
You were misinformed. We're a training company, we're not devil worshippers. What kind of a question is that?
So you've no interest in the occult?
No, Inspector, I have no interest in the occult any more than I have interest in pool vaulting, cheese making, or snake charming. Anything else you want to know that I'm not interested in?
That's fine, thanks. Tell me a bit about this, please. It's the Atlas Aptitude Test.
What do you want to know?
What does it test, exactly?
It's a test we introduced to make sure that any students didn't have any major personality problems, skeletons in the cupboard, so to speak. We introduced it because we had a little bit of a problem with one of the students.
Lisa.
You are well informed.
And what do you think it was that disturbed her?
I believe that the course proved to be too demanding for her. We discovered that she had one or two psychological problems and she couldn't handle it.
And did you change anything else on the course, apart from introducing the test?
We increased the entrance age to 21. Well, wasn't much, but it's about the only thing we could do. We didn't want another Lisa. We didn't want students turning round and suing us, did we?
Aha. So nobody has ever been affected by auto-hypnosis, except Lisa.
Hypnosis wasn't the problem, Inspector. Lisa was the problem with Lisa. That's why we introduced the test.
But the hypnosis was the trigger, wasn't it?
Lisa arrived on the course believing we were all devil worshippers. She was nuts to start with. We didn't make her like that.
Well, as far as I can tell, Paul, you've had one student accuse you of devil worship and two others commit suicide. Some of your students aren't having a very good time on this course, are they?
Nonsense. Kate was enjoying every minute of it. She couldn't get enough of it.
Really?
She was full of the joys of life. Bubbly, confident, flirty.
With who?
You mean with whom?
With whom?
Pretty much everybody. Including me, as I remember.
Really? And did you respond?
I don't get into relationships with students, Inspector. Company policy. It's not professional.
Interesting admission that Kate flirted with him. There's no way Paul would have turned down an opportunity like that.
You say you didn't know Emma, yet you bought her a freedom necklace.
I don't remember saying anything about buying Emma a necklace.
So you didn't buy her one? So you did buy her one. So that means you must have known her, and quite well too.
Stop making such a big thing about this, Inspector. Look, I've been around a few years. The clock is ticking, and I admit I have an embarrassing weakness for attractive women. It was a stupid mistake, but that's all it was.
So you're saying you tried it on with her?
No, I didn't try it on. I bought her a necklace. I'm not aware that there's a law against buying presents, unless, of course, the Third Reich has been elected. While I was at a bridge party, Emma was old enough to make decisions for herself. And as a matter of fact, she decided that she didn't want to be bothered with an old fool like me. So nothing happened, no mistakes, nobody got hurt. All right.
Like father, like son. No surprises there. I wonder how many students Paul has tried it on with.
So you avoid relationships with students, except for Emma, who you tried to date.
Oh, come on, Inspector, that was a long time ago.
And what about Kate Vine? Did you try to date her or not?
Oh, don't be so ridiculous, Inspector. Kate was an exceptionally clever girl. She knew exactly what she wanted, and she knew how to get it.
You mean that Kate approached you?
It wouldn't surprise me if she was playing everyone in the group. Kate had more enemies than you'd think. She was a very, very manipulative young woman.
Ten o'clock, it's getting late. I'm going to have to pick up the pace if I'm going to solve this by midnight.